Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Tonight we're going to look at Python Pandas. It's a framework for Python, which enables you to do all the operations that you usually would do inside a spreadsheet. So it means that you can get data, which is called data frames. That's the whole data set. Then you can also manipulate the series. You can manipulate single values inside your data frame. It's almost like fiddling with a with a spreadsheet, but just inside Python, where you have all the strings to call all of those pieces of Python there. Let us get started. First of all, the documentation for Python Pandas is awesome, and it can be found at the pandas.python.org. And you have the documentation right there in the right side, where it says web right there. And you go to the user guide. This is not the right place. Let me just check. Oh, that was the wrong. Did I press the wrong link there? I think I did. Let me just press this page right here. Documentation web. There's something wrong with the web page right now. Okay, that came. I just refreshed it. Then you want to press the user guide right there. And what is wrong? I have to refresh all the pages. I don't know what's wrong right now, but it's never mind. It's here. Then you have all of the documentation. There are 10 minutes to Pandas, so if you want to get started really fast, then whenever you're stuck doing stuff, then you can actually read about it right here. Also, how to handle XML, JSON, CSV, HTML, etc. And also how to manipulate data and how to save data again. I'm going to use Anaconda because that is a cool environment handling framework for Python. You can also use pip if you want to do that. And you can easily create a new environment with Anaconda by writing something like, I'm using WSL for Windows, so that means Windows Subsystem for Linux. You can just create a new one writing conda. Minus conda create minus n, and then give it a good name. Python demo, let us call this pandas python demo 3, like this. And then you can choose your Python version just by applying Python and then equal to and then a version like this. Now I'm actually getting this environment right here. Then I can install the Pandas Python library, which is quite easy. And if you don't know how to install that that framework, then you can actually go to the documentation right here, which is quite awesome. You can go to here right here. You can also use Jupyter. I'm using the PyCharm, which is a JetBrains IDE, Integrated Development Environment. But you can also use Jupyter, where you can just sit and click around and write stuff inside a terminal in a browser, if that's what you want to do. Let me just show you something right here. You actually just write install pandas, and then you actually get that pandas right there. So I'll write conda activate. First, I need to activate this new environment that I created right here. This conda activate, and then conda install pandas like this. Then I'm installing the pandas framework, the library, and all the dependencies to that library. And that's actually it. Now I can actually start using using pandas. And as you can see here, right, that's actually a good dependency to NumPy. NumPy is excellent and awesome for handling arrays and also to handle multi-dimensional data. So if you're a data scientist, you will love pandas, but you would also love NumPy. Now let us actually dig right into it. I have some data right here. I have not written all of this in manually. this is actually some data that I generated through a Python script, and I'll just go through just quickly how I actually generated this data right here. But as you can see, I have one column with a spaceship, then I have a captain, then I have a fuel percentage right there, and the fuel percentage, that's a number between 0 and 100. Let's just go into the code so we can see how to do that. Create data. So this is the first file that we have right here. And let me just close the other tabs like that. So I'm importing random because I need some random numbers. I'm using pandas as PD because that's why every time I write PD, then it's actually pandas. I also need NumPy to create this data right here. And there's an alias right there as NP right there. And then I've created a list right here. So I have a ship first name. So what I'm actually doing is I've created this list of first names for ships. Then I have a last part of the ship right here, which is like cruiser or freight. And then I combine these two to create a random spaceship. So I take one random element from this list right here. Then I take another random element from this list right here. And then I say that is a spaceship. So for instance, if I could take Sky from the first list and then Bird for the other list, and then I'll get a spaceship named Sky Bird. I do the same with the captain, Mike, and then it could be Mike Happy, because I just take two words right there. And this is the function where I actually do the stuff. So I have this list of spaceships right here, and then I say do this 100 times, and then I create a name, which is a random, where I take the random part from the first captain first part and the captain last part, do the same with ship. I'm capitalizing the text, so I actually so the mic will be with capital M, uppercase M, and then lowercase rest. So the rest of it, and that is why I'm calling this capitalized right there. The fuel percentage, I'm calculating that as a random number between 0 and 100. Then I'm appending to my Python list right there. Every time I go through the loop, and then in the end, I'm returning this list right there. And this is the code that actually calls it. First of all, I create a new data frame. That is, everything. Just think of this as a spreadsheet. Every tab you have in your spreadsheet, every kind of table you have in your spreadsheet, that is a data frame when you are dealing with pandas. So this just means that I have some data that I want to create. And I can actually create a new data frame on a NumPy array, and that is why I need the NumPy import right here. So I'm creating a NumPy array right here from a normal list right here, which we have right here. So that is pretty awesome. Then I give it some columns right here. So this is the column names that I give right here. Then with a data format, data frame, then I can always tail it and get the last elements by calling the tail function. I can also get the first elements with the dot head function. And I'm doing that a lot, actually. And then we have the describe that describes the whole thing. I actually don't need that right now. Shape is very important. That will tell you the dimensions of your data frame. That means that if you have 16 rows, then it will be 16. And then if you have three columns, then it will be comma 3. Then that will be the shape. This is the dimensions of your data frame. This is where I save it to a HTML file. I can also save it and represent it as a comma separated values file, CSV's comma separated value. And of course you can choose the separator to be a tab instead if you want to do that. That's very easy. But for now, let us just name this spaceship 3 and spaceship underscore 3 comma separated values file right there. Then we are going to run this program right here, create data. Then we'll see if it works. This is the result. You can see I got run here a spaceship named Laser Freight and a captain named KT Brain and a fuel of 30. And why would I do this? This is simply just to generate some data so we have something to extract. And as you can see right here, I can actually look at the HTML. This is the HTML file that was generated. And as you can probably see already now, there is actually a column that is generated for us automatically. That is the index column. And that is because there was no index defined already in this data frame right here. Then pandas is so nice that it actually creates an index for us. This means that we have a unique index right here as the first column. And this can it's always good to have a unique index for your data, because then it's easy to take row number 4, and then you can go manipulate the spaceship name right there. It's much easier to, if when you can refer to something that is unique for your for each row. Then we have the comma separated values file right here. This is the if you want to have them represented like the comma separated value, and then it would look like this. As you can see right now here, each row is separated by a new line. Pretty awesome also. I've already done this and prepared this already. That's why I named this file number 3, because actually I have already I already have a number 1 right here, which is right here. So this is my number 1 file. And this is, of course, the HTML file for the number 1. And we are going to manipulate and to use the number 1, the one without underscore 3. So let me just adjust a filter right here on the... Let me just adjust a filter. I think it's a little bit better now. Let's see. Oh, it's still not, still not good. Or maybe I'll just like this. It did not help that much. Okay, I guess it's okay. I guess it was better for before. Let us just leave that for now. So. That is the field. So those are the settings we're going to use. Okay, so now we have a data. So now we have some data. What can we now do with this data through Pandas? We can do a lot. Let me just tell you that. First of all, we can get a partial. We can read the data. And with reading the data is quite easy. We import Pandas as PD as usual. We always do that, by the way. So if you see something called PD somewhere, then it's just because we have imported Pandas up in the top of the file. Here we have pd.speech.csv, and that means that I'm just importing the CSV as a data frame. Here, this is the location of my file, .spaceships right there. The index column, I have to set that, because if I don't set that, then I will Pandas will actually think that there's no index, and then it will create a new column with unique indexes. So so you have to tell if you have an index column in your data, then you have to say which column is the index column. Or else you leave it out, and then Pandas will create a new index column for you. Here I'm printing out the first 3 lines. Let me just show you that actually. So now I'm printing out df head 3. So now I'll just get a representation of my data frame. I'll get the first 3 rows. And as you can see right here, yes, it looks beautiful. And of course, just for fun, let us also look at the tail. And I'm pressing Shift F10 to run again. You can always do that in PyCharm. And there's both a free version, there's also a paid for version with PyCharm. For all the things that we're doing right here, the free version is the community edition is okay, it's fine and to use for you. And here you can see that those are the last 3 last 2 rows inside the data frame. So yeah, right, quite cool. So now let us try to fetch some partial data. If I want to get some indexes, maybe I want to have index 6 to 10 maybe, then I'll just write 6:10. If I only want to get 2 columns out, then I can just mention the columns in a list or in an array right here. If I only want to get the caption out, then I'll just mention the caption. If I also want the fuel, then I'll also mention the fuel right there. And then I'm creating a new data frame named DF partial, and then I can print out that DF partial right there. And I can print out the last 10. There's only 4 rows, so 10 will be fine. Press Shift 10, run again. And let us see what actually happens right here. Now I only get the caption out. Of course, I still have the indexes. The indexes are handled in a special way with Pandas. It's not like a column. It's not to be considered a column. It is to be considered indexes, which it is, right? So here we have the caption. And if I also want fuel, then I'll just add that to my df log. As you can see right here, I'm calling the log right here on the data frame, and then I get the and then I will get that. So as you can see right here, that is the okay. Yeah, the log is quite useful, and it's used a lot to extract the data. So then you can both say which rows you want and also which columns you want out. Let us press Shift of 10 again. Now I also get the fuel, as you can see right here, with the log, df.log. Okay, then if another way to get partial data is actually to put in a condition, that means I can actually run df.log, and then I can say, give me all of those where fuel percentage is less than 20. And again, I can say I only want these two columns right here. Now, this time it's the spaceship I want and it's the fuel percentage I want. Then I can get that data out. And now I can see now it's only the fuel, now it's only the spaceships, but fuel percentage less than is less than 20. Quite awesome. That is how easy it is actually to get data out. What, how do we add data if we want to insert data into a new column? It is also quite easy. We read the file as usual, like that. Then we, I'm printing out the shape, and that's how it looks already in the beginning. Yeah, the reason why I print out the shape here is actually because I want to show you what the shape is before I insert a column, and I want to show you what the shape is after I insert a column. This time I want to insert a new column, and I want to insert it at a column index 2. And that is the number of crashes. And I have determined that the number of crashes actually is a function of the fuel percentage, and I divide that by 2. And true, that just means that it's non-unique. It's okay with duplicate values. That is what the last argument there shows you. So df insert, and as you can see right here, the function actually makes sense. It is actually what you would expect when you insert something. You actually insert something. They actually insert some data. So quite awesome. And then I'm actually creating randoms right here. That means I'm creating a randoms list, because I need to have just as many values as we already have. I want to have as many values as we already have rows. That means I'm using the shape right there. Df shape 0. That will give me the number of rows. And then I say, please NumPy random, generate some random integers from 2 to 10. And you should do that 100 times, because I know there's 100 rows inside this data frame right here. And then insert it at the column index 1, and then name the column crew. And then, insert all of these random values. And again, there can be duplicates. It's not unique values. This is how I insert two different columns, and let us just look at how it looks now. First we have the spaceship, now we have the crew, because the crew was inserted in index 1, and then we have the captain, then we have number of crashes, then we have fuel, and as you can see right here, the crashes is actually the fuel percentage divided by 2 all the way down, and the number of crews is just a random number. So that is how we would insert, and look at the shape. This is the shape, this is the how our data frame looks like. We have 100 rows, we have 3 columns. When we are done, then we have 100 rows, we have 5 columns right there, because we inserted 2 columns. That is awesome, right? That's cool. Then we have, then we can count data. If you want to count, then that is actually, we can actually just call count. What count does actually is actually a little bit weird, but let us try it out. Because again, here we load the same data. I'm printing out 10 rows just so we can see how it looks like, and then we call count. Look what actually happens with count. It actually says how many values do we have per column, and that is because we do not need to have a value in each for each row. We could actually have not a value. That is actually allowed. It's allowed to not to have a value present for any field inside this data frame, and that is why that is what this count tells us. It actually tells us that there's we actually have values in all of the columns right now. If we had one of them where it would be not a value, then we would actually then it would the number would be lower than 100 there, and that is of course that is possible. You can also say that you want to count you want to count on the other axis on the columns instead. Then you just write axis columns. Now for each row. Then for each row, and this is the index that we see in the left side right there, then we get the number of values that we have in this row. And again, if you had not a value somewhere, then then you would are not defined. Then you would actually then this number would be less than 3. Of course, right now we have 3 values per row right now, because we have the spaceships, we have the captains, and we have the fuel percentage. Now let us try to do something a bit more useful with the counts, because there's actually something called value count, and that is much more interesting. Because if I get this if I use value count and then I give it a column this argument, there's a value counts function right there, then I can actually see how many core column captains I actually have in my data frame. I have 5 of these. That is because I created random captains, but it was from a limited set. You saw how many first names and last names I actually had. There was not that many actually, so that means that I actually have 5 core columns inside my data set. So if I go look in my CSV file, then I would find 5 core. So let me just go to a search for that. Core like this. Core column like this. There was 1, and you can actually already see that I got this 1 out of 5 in the top right here. That is a pie chart that tells me that. And of course, I can find them right there. So I have 5 of those. Pretty cool, pretty awesome. That is the values count. And I think that's much more useful. At least I use that a bit more often. So then there's another thing. If you want to have that, if you want to get that values count and we want to use that as a column instead, that we can actually say I want all of the captions where there's more than 3 captions of the same name, then I want all of those rows out. Then we have to do a small trick right here, and that is what I'm doing right here. I'm creating the values count, then I'm renaming the axis, because an axis will actually be created when we call this function right here that is named unique values. So we're renaming that, and I could have named this Mike instead. Then I'm actually writing uniques. Instead, I could actually have called it value count or something like that. It's up to you can call whatever you want, right? So the important thing is that now this is a column. So that means that if you only want those rows where that column is greater than 3, for instance, then you need to use the same name right here. So that's a small this is a panda trick that you can use, where you rename the unique values right there, and then you can. And you reset the index like this to value count like that. And that this means that this little trick actually enables us to use this as a column actually. So let us try to see how it looks when we print out this data right here. So now I can actually see it, and now I get unique values, value count, and then I get core column out. Thomas Cowboy, Thomas Charming. It just renamed this column right here. Actually, I don't need this actually. I think. Do I? Reset index. Let me just try something that just for fun. See, now it's still called caption, but that was just if I want to rename the. If I want to rename the axis, then that's how you do it. But you don't have to do that. But you have to reset the index to something else. That's just how it works when you are creating a count like this. And what else I want to show you? Sorting is also easy. You can just call data frame sort values, and then you just say which column you want to sort your data on, and then should it be ascending or descending, then you just choose that right there. And let us call this code right here. So this is straightforward. It's just to show you that if you want to sort data by fuel descending as we do right here, then it's fine. If you have multiple values, then Mike is before Rick, because M is before R in the alphabet, and we chose true as ascending on the captains right there. So that is the sorting. This is actually it. If you are playing a lot with Python and you don't want to right click and say run like I do all the time, if you want that little green arrow in the left side, then you can make this if sentence right here. If underscore underscore name equals to main, then do something right here. And then that means that now you actually get a small green arrow that you can press instead. And of course you can just do whatever you want to write here. You can just write begin end like this. And now I have a small button right there. I can click. It's just a, yeah, it's just a small trick. If you want to click the button instead of right clicking, because Shift F10 only works when you already have run something, then it will rerun the last thing that you ran. So it's not enough just to have put focus on the file. You have first to either run by right click run main like this, or press the little green button in the left side right there. I hope you enjoyed this video, Pandas. There's much more to Pandas than I've showed you right here. I just want to give you a short introduction to how to actually to use Pandas. Yeah. Was there anything else? I think there's one more thing I would like to do, actually. I would actually let us get partial data right there. I'm going to place all of this code on GitHub as usual, and I'm placing the link in the description below. What was it I want to show you? Here we have the captains, right? Let us run this data first, right? That was something I wanted to show you also. Here we get three rows out. We have an index. Yeah, okay. I actually want this index right here. Because let us say that I want to set. Is it dot log? I can call like this, 797 like this. Then I can say captain. And I can set this value to something like hello. Isn't that true? I'm not sure, as you can hear right now. But you can set each field value. Yes, as you can see right here. Now I actually took out one. Now I took out one field. I took this this row right here with this index right here, 97. And then I say I want to say set the captain to hello. And that's exactly what I did right here. It's just to show how you would manipulate one single field. And of course, you can set multiple values here also if you want to. I'm not sure if it's this easy actually, but let us just try. So see if I can just give an array or list right here, fuel, and then we'll say 2%. Oh, I know it's doesn't make sense, but let us just press play anyway. Yeah. So this is actually how easy we can actually set this just to show that the captain value also changes. So this is how you can actually set, this is how you can set values. You can use the .loc to get the data out, and you can manipulate it like this. That is actually it. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you again soon. Have a great evening. Bye-bye.